are burning, but faces looking away. People are yearning for someone to show them the way. Tables keep turning.
We've got $1,000 worth of donations from individuals, and then we've got a $300 donation from Bunnings and McGrath's Hill.
Oh my god, I had no idea!
My name's Belinda Honeysett. I'm the Station Officer and Catering Officer for Bell Bush Fire Brigade.
I'm Nicole Hopkins, and I help Belinda out.
She's my boss. Bell's out and whoop whoop. Bell's about 25 k's.
Yep.
Yeah, from Lithgow. This fire brought the community closer together than we have been for a long time. All voluntary. So yep. None of us get paid one little bit. So, and but I don't think anyone would change that either. So.
We need sprinkler systems for the roof.
Yep.
So that if the fire comes through again, then we'll be safe.
Yep. Yep. And the people that ends up here will be safe too.
Good afternoon. My name is Henry Kerwin. I'm Senior Deputy Captain at Clarence Dargan Brigade. Some time ago I was approached by Sydney Convoy Mission asking what help could be afforded to our members. Well, up to six of our members lost their homes during the fire. And I sent that information to the company, and they apparently have got in contact with some of our members. We're very hard hit here. Up to 34 houses, I believe, may have been damaged or lost between Clarence and Dargan. And as you can see, looking around you, we are still trying to recover. This is my home behind me. It survived the fires. However, my workshops at the back didn't survive. But compared to my two neighbours on the left of me, I'm in a much better position than they could ever be. And I'd like to thank you guys for coming around and offering whatever help you could to our members and to the local community. Yes, landscaping, as you can see, this took 11 years to build up. My wife built this over 11 years and it's gone. But we're looking in and we can see green shoots coming out. So we're hoping in the next couple of months we will start building our home again. Or build our home's fine, but building our garden back to what it was.
That's an aluminium rim. That's how hot it was, all this heat.
My name's Dargan. Tony. I live in Dargan. I couldn't get into the property because it was blocked. I got a couple of cars out, but I lost a lot of stuff. And I need a bit of help. If someone's willing to help.
What are the main sort of things that are affecting you right now? So you were mentioning before about the electricity, so the problems.
Yeah, I need a bit of help with the electricity, and the water tanks needs to be probably checked. Needs to be checked, and then you'll see if it's cracked, and then see if it's worth putting water in it.
Yeah.
The shed's completely gone.
And tell us about your tractor.
And the tractor was here. I got it cheap, but it went as quick as I didn't even get to use it. And just can't be helped. And it'd be good if someone could help.
Mm. Yeah. Alright. Well, look, we'll see what we can do on our end. We'll be putting this out and talking to people and see if we can get some people up here to help you. And yeah, we'll try our very best.
Alright, thank you for that.
No, I know. It's, wow. I'm sorry this has happened to you.
But, yeah, you wouldn't be the only one, but thank you.
No, no worries.
Thank you.
I hope things get better soon.
Hi everybody, I'm Dave Wilpaw. I live in Dargan. We've just gone through the most horrific experience of our life. We had a fire come over the hill from Clarence on the 21st at about 4:25. The fire was incredibly high. It was as high as you could see into the sky. We had prepared, but I wasn't real sure whether we were going to survive this one. But as it is, we have survived. We cleared thoroughly. We built for the fires. And if anybody would like to talk to me about this, I can give them some hints and advice about building in this environment to survive a fire like we've had. It's really sad that we've lost houses behind us, over the road. We've lost 17 houses in the street in total. It's really depressing to walk out of the house and see that. It makes you sick in the stomach. But I've been told by several of my neighbours that they're going to build again. And if I can give them advice, I will. And I'm willing to give anybody advice as to what you need to do in this environment to survive a catastrophe like this.